Okay. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Yeah, today is weekend, Tony. I've come to just first thank you all for connecting with us always. Yesterday night, you were online with us, for the tarry night, and we still have to connect together today for the weekend tonic. So I want to just excuse me, appreciate that it may seem burning of your data, but it has great benefit, to share together, to learn together. So welcome to the Weekend Tonic. MSC Oladejo is still my name. I'm the lead pastor of the Lord's Portion Restorers Church. Today we again want to continue on the last time we met. We were talking about strategy turning to tragedy, and we ended it with some prayers. But today is just sharing together, right? We want to thank God that the COVID-19 it's finding a way of having its graph, flattened gradually, especially in this part of the world. So we want to thank God for that, and I want to appreciate all of you that have always joined us in praying. Since we started to add prayer to the protocol. But today, as we look at, we continue to look at strategy, how strategy turned to tragedy, right? And I would like to again say that strategy that will lead to success must be void of craftiness. And there are some other ingredients that your strategy, if you want your strategies to have good success, there are some other ingredients that you must avoid, right? And we want to learn from how the strategy, in fact, the tragedy that has brought us to this end from the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth. We have come into, this tragic experience of sin and of lot of calamities everywhere, just because in the beginning there was an adopted strategy that Satan used, and the strategy Satan used had some content. And these are the contents I want us to avoid, right? If you want to succeed and you want to have good, clean success in business, it's possible. If you want to use strategies, it's possible for you to use your strategies clean and you will have clean success. You don't need to, let your strategies be encumbered with contents that are detrimental. And I want to share three things with you today that you must avoid in your strategies. Three things to avoid. There are many things that that encapsulate our strategies when we want to maybe do business, want to start ministry, or you want to start a new business, you want to start a new venture, you want to do something new, and you are strategizing, you are trying to strategize. But there are some things that must not be in the content of your strategy. And that's what I want to share with you today. Because the devil came with a strategy, the strategy that has brought us this tragedy in the beginning, right? And it is from that we want to share. When some ingredients are in your strategies, they become very, very dangerous and they become very tragic. These ingredients will make your strategy to become very, very tragic at the end. Now, let me read to us Genesis chapter 3. Genesis chapter 3, that's where we're coming from. That's where we're picking this thought from. Genesis chapter 3, verse 1 to 3. Let me just read it. It says, the serpent was the craftiest of all, you know, the serpent was the craftiest of all the creatures the Lord God had made. So the serpent came to the woman. Really? He asked, none of the fruit of the garden, God says, you mustn't eat any of it. Of course, we may eat it, the woman told him. It's only the fruit from the tree at the center of the garden that we are not to eat. God says we mustn't eat it or even touch it, or we will die. Now, there are some things in this strategy that the devil decided to use, that the serpent decided to use, that I want to advise that you must always avoid this content in your strategy. When you are using strategies to start business, you are using strategy or you're adopting strategy to start ministry or to start any venture, like I said. So these are the contents I have found in the strategy that the devil came to use in the beginning. The contents are this, and you must avoid them. If not, your strategies will, at the end, it won't give you, your strategy will not give you good success. But yeah, it may give you tragic success. Tragic success. And what are the contents? Number one, content to avoid in your strategy is impersonation. Impersonation. If you are strategizing your business, avoid impersonation. You will see, using the body of a serpent and speaking like human being, you know, was not his real personality. That wasn't his real personality. He only came using the voice of human being and using serpent. The Satan is not a serpent, but he used that body. And you can imagine a serpent speaking. You can imagine. That's impersonation. Impersonation of the highest order. I mean, he didn't even come using serpent body alone. He used serpent body and he now spoke like human beings. You know, the only time we heard when animals spoke in the scripture, you know, I mean, the second time anyway, was when Balaam's donkey spoke to his master. You know, the donkey spoke. But this first one is impersonation. Wow. Impersonation of the highest order. Look at it. You know, Bible also says that Satan has the ability to impersonate even angel of light. Even angel of light, he can impersonate. That's what the Bible says. Look at 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 14. The Bible says this. It says, yet I am not surprised. Satan can change himself into an angel of light. You know. So he came very subtly. He came to the woman and impersonated, using the voice of a human being and using the body of a serpent. But we all know that Satan was the one that did this, right? Impersonation anywhere in the world is a criminal offense. Impersonation, it is a criminal offense. You know, sometimes you see people that are not, you know, that are not in the military setup and they wear uniform. You know, that's impersonation. It's a serious, anywhere in the world, impersonation is a serious criminal offense. When a criminal intent is sponsoring your strategy, it becomes very toxic. It becomes very, very tragic, right? So never let criminal intent to sponsor your strategies. Don't impersonate. You want to strategize to have a business. Make your strategy neat so that you can have good success. Let your strategy be void. Let your strategy be void of impersonation. Don't impersonate anybody. You know, the last time I was talking about, you know, I was talking about this in another way, right? The last time we prayed, the first time we talked about strategy turned to tragedy. You know, be yourself. Don't impersonate. And that was the content of the strategy of Satan, right, in the beginning, that brought us into this strategy, into this tragedy. So avoid impersonation in your strategy for your business, for your, you want to start a ministry, you want to start a church, you want to start anything, and you are adopting strategies. Avoid impersonation. Avoid it. It's a criminal offense. Don't let impersonation, you know, fuel your strategies. Don't let it be in the content of your strategy. Another thing, because of our time, another thing that you must avoid in your strategy is subtle word manipulation. It was included in the content of devil's, you know, the devil's, Satan's strategy. Avoid it in your own content. Avoid subtle word manipulation. Don't manipulate anything. If you want your strategy to bring you good success, don't manipulate anything. God, you see, if you look at, you know, Genesis chapter 3, when the devil was using this strategy, you know, to attain his end, you know, impersonation first, and he now came with subtly, he came with word manipulation, right? God never said, look at it, Genesis chapter 3, you know, verse 3, God never said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden. God never said that. God never said they shall not eat of any tree. When did God say that one? He never said it. God rather said, of every tree of the garden, you may freely eat. In fact, God told them they may freely eat. But the devil came with a strategy that turned into tragedy. He came, and the content of his strategy was to manipulate God's word. He said, you shall not eat of every. God never said they shall not eat of every. God only said, of every of the tree of the garden, you may freely eat. But God gave them exemption of one they shouldn't eat. So that was word manipulation, right? In Genesis chapter 2 verse 16, you will see what God actually said. God said, of every tree of the garden, you may freely eat. He only gave an exemption that don't touch this, don't eat this, right? And you will see, when alteration and manipulation join hands to make your strategy, it will obviously make the strategy to become tragic. It will obviously make your strategy to turn to tragedy. Don't alterate, don't manipulate. Go straight, let your strategy do. If you do hard work with your strategies, you can achieve good success. Never attempt to achieve tragic success. Success that you cannot defend at the end of the day. Success that you cannot be proud of. Success that you will not be able to come out to say, oh, thank God I achieved this. Let your strategies be void of impersonation. Don't impersonate anybody. Be yourself. Be who you are. Be who God has made you to be. Don't let your strategy, you know, have the content of manipulation. You can see how he manipulated what God has said, the instruction God had given. He manipulated it very subtly, you know. And the woman, you know, fell into it. And that's what has brought us into this tragedy till date, you know. So never let truth be altered. Or don't never let truth be altered. Never let truth be manipulated as falsehood. You know, I remember then when we were in school, you know, in philosophy, when you are defining falsehood. Falsehood is a type of truth a type of fruit that is manipulated, you know. So don't manipulate the truth. Don't manipulate. Don't alter anything in your strategy, right? Let your strategy be true. When your strategy formula is truth minus manipulation, then the formula becomes good success. It will be easy equals to good success. Good success. It will be easy equals to good success. You know, so that's what you must know about strategy. Sorry for that. That was power outrage. All right, but I mean, we can still move on. You know, the top thing that you must avoid in the content of your strategy is discrediting others to credit yourself. Don't discredit others because you want to credit yourself. No, don't do it. Don't discredit others, right? Don't discredit others. If you want to do, you want to do business, you want to go into ministry, you want to do politics, you know, I see a lot of politicians do this. Even some organizations, they do this. They discredit others to credit themselves. You know, such is not good in your strategy. If you make that a content in your strategy, it will lead to tragedy. Never let discrediting others be a content of your strategy. You know, don't discredit others to credit yourself. The serpent practically discredited God in his strategy. He discredited God, you know, and look at what he said in Genesis chapter 3 verse 4. Look at what he said. He said, that is a lie. He told the woman, he said, that is a lie. The serpent is, you will not surely die. Eh? God lying. He was trying to discredit God, to credit himself, to give credit to his strategies that he was trying to use, discrediting God. Don't discredit others. And I see that in organizations. Many organizations do that. You see it in their advert, right? They will, maybe some of these organizations or company that produce household things, you know, they will put others and they will put them, they will just slot them up and bring their home. Don't discredit others. Do hard work. If you do hard work, you know, about your strategies and about your project, people will actually, you know, buy your project. People will buy your product. Right, you don't need to discredit others because you want to credit, you know, your own product, and that's what you must avoid. I see many organizations do that several times, and I feel it's wrong to discredit others because you want to credit. And you see, even our politicians, you will see election is about at the corner. You will see some of our politicians, they will be discrediting others, and that's what Satan came to do here. He said, that's a lie. The serpent is, you will not surely die. And God, I mean, he was trying to discredit God, saying that God was lying, right? So I believe if you do hard work, you want to start a business, if you really do hard work and you work hard on your strategies, you don't need to discredit others to credit yourself. You don't need to do that. You don't need to bring others down because you want to come up. You don't need to do that. Don't bring others down because you want to rise. If you do your visibility study well and you see faults in your competitors, you see faults in your competitors, just magnify, you know, magnify that aspect of the fault in your own advert. Don't bring them down. Just magnify that you are bringing this product to solve this problem that your competitor didn't solve. And that's a good strategy. It will yield you good success. But people are not going for good success anymore. But for you, the tonic today, go for good success. Let your strategies be void of impersonation. Let it be void of subtle manipulation, subtle word manipulation, and let it be void of discrediting others to credit yourself, right? And so these are the words I want to share with you today in this tonic. I believe you have been blessed. This is just 20 minutes meeting. I believe you have been blessed. Please stay blessed. And I wish you a good weekend. It's the season of rain. The rain has come. Let every one of us utilize this time very productively. And I believe God will bless you. Will you please join us again tomorrow at the service? We'll be talking and looking at landmarks. Landmarks. Many landmarks have been removed. And we'll be looking at landmarks tomorrow. So I want to appreciate you for joining me. Thank you always for, having to bond your data to connect for us to share together. God bless you. Thank you for being part of the Weekend Tonic. I look forward to seeing you again and again, and especially tomorrow for service. God bless you. Oladejo MC is still my name, your brother and your friend. Thank you for being part of the Weekend Tonic. Stay well.